move on to our income and expenses, which is the next part of the workbook, we just want to put that away for a moment. And I want you to ask yourself a question of how much do you actually need to live on? Now, if I ask this in a group of people like I did in our live seminars, the numbers vary a lot. You'll see someone with $25,000 on their age pension that can live on that. Then you'll have another person that says that if they had anything less than $140,000 a year, they would struggle to do the things that were important to them. So this number is obviously going to vary greatly from one person to the next. And I want you to know that there's no right answer with it. To give you an idea though of what might be viewed as average, ASFA actually have put together some retirement standards on what they see as being average expenses for people that are in retirement. So according to ASFA, for a modest lifestyle in retirement, a couple needs $39,252 a year. A single person needs $27,000 a year. To live comfortably in retirement, they say a couple needs just on $60,000, while a person needs just over $42,000. So I don't know how they get the numbers, but let's have a look at what they can actually do for you. So I've put together a table at what your expenses might be on these kind of income levels. So if we go through the ones that are a comfortable retirement, we can see that you'd be able to afford the following. You'd be able to have an annual holiday in Australia, not an overseas one, unless of course you can do that really cheaply. You could eat out at a restaurant with good food quite regularly. You could afford a reasonable car. You could afford bottled wine. This one is really important to me, and so the moment I saw this, I knew I needed a comfortable retirement lifestyle. You can afford to buy new clothes. You can afford a regular haircut at your normal hairdresser. You can afford to take part in a range of leisure activities, like your membership to your local golf club. You can also continue with your private health insurance. So just remember that to do this, they've said that a couple would have to have just on $60,000, while a single person would have to have just over $42,000. Okay, let's move into the middle column and we'll have a look at what a modest lifestyle would provide. That is if a couple has $40,000 a year and a single person has just on $27,000. So the lifestyle that they can afford looks like this middle column. On these numbers, you can see that you can have one or two short breaks in Australia, but really around where you live, not hopping on a plane to do this. You can eat out at restaurants, but it is the cheaper restaurants that you're going to and not as often. You're probably looking at your local Chinese or the local pub, unless you live on the Gold Coast like I do, where somehow the pub food seems to cost as much as some of your fancy restaurants. You can afford wine, but you're going back to cask wine now. You can afford some new clothes and reasonable clothes, but you're not buying designer brands on this kind of income. You can afford your regular haircuts, although you are looking at going to one of the more basic salons or going on pensioner special days. You might be able to take some part in paid leisure activities every now and then, and possibly go to the movies every now and then as well. And you can still afford your private health insurance. Now, I know that there's been a lot of talk about how you can afford to live on just the age pension, and that is the reality for a lot of Australians. And you can do it, but this is what it looks like. So you might be able to have short breaks in an area around your day trips in your own city as your holidays or as your getaway. You're not really going away and paying for apartments. Your meals out really are the club special meals or really inexpensive takeouts. If you have a car, it's probably becoming a bit of a struggle to pay for the repairs or the registration on it. Alcohol doesn't really look great. If you were to buy alcohol, it's going to be at the expense of something else unless you're home brewing, because there's really no allowance for alcohol at all in just an age pension. You may choose to buy alcohol, but it means that you're probably eating out or getting haircuts or going to the cinema even less regularly. Clothing becomes very basic and you're not able to afford new clothes on a regular basis. Haircuts as well are now getting infrequent, or you're getting one of your friends to cut your hair. Leisure activities really now are the free council-provided activities or community activities that are in your area. and possibly a trip to the cinema every now and then on pension, a special day for a special occasion. And again, now there's no allowance in these numbers for maintaining any private health insurance. It's easy to see as well how the numbers can go up from here. You can see there's no allowance for international travel, no allowance for going and seeing the grandkids in a different state a couple of times a year, no allowance in there for helping the grandkids with school fees, and there's absolutely no allowance in there for pets. So you can see that these numbers are really just starting points, and it would be very easy for them to go up from here. What it does provide though is a bit of an average for you, so that when you do your expenses in the next video, you can start to bring those back to whether or not they're actually realistic, or whether you might be forgetting a few things along the line. So on that, let's head to the next video where we actually have a look at your income and expenses that are realistic for you, rather than just plucking out some average or ASFA retirement standards or some other random number that may make absolutely no sense whatsoever for you to use. I'll see you on the next video.